Hey everyone, it's me, Ms. Crichton. Our FQ today is, what rights does the Bill of Rights protect? And our Do Now question is, what rights do people have in the United States? Pause the video now and take a few minutes to make a list of all the rights you can think of. Today we're starting a new unit on policing. In this unit, we'll be debating the best way to stop the police from abusing their power. The issue of policing is all over the news right now. The protests over the summer against police violence and systemic racism were the biggest protest movements in U.S. history. 26 million people participated. So we're living through an important historical moment, and we want to help you understand it. But before we get into talking about the police, we're going to start by talking about the rights that all people in the United States have. Tomorrow, we'll talk about some of the ways police violate these rights. The United States Constitution contains a really important list of our rights. The Constitution is a document that basically spells out the rules for how our national government works. It's a law, but it's more important than any regular law. It's like the highest law in the land, meaning every national, state, and city law has to conform to the rules in the Constitution. At the end of the Constitution are a list of amendments, which are changes or additions to the Constitution. The first 10 amendments were added all at the same time in 1791, when the Constitution was still brand new. Those first 10 amendments are called the Bill of Rights. That's the document we're going to study today. These amendments mostly use the word people instead of citizen. So today, judges interpret this to mean any people on U.S. soil have these rights, whether they're citizens or not. But it wasn't always understood that way in the past. By the way, I'm going to mention this because sometimes students get this confused. The Ten Amendments are not the same thing as the Ten Commandments. The Ten Commandments are a list of rules in the Bible, Quran, and Torah. But today we're talking about the first 10 amendments to the Constitution. The graded activity in this lesson is a Schoology discussion, which is in the same folder. Post your answers to these questions in the comment box in the discussion. For all three of these questions, make sure you explain why. Then you're going to respond to at least one other student explaining why you agree or disagree with them or asking a question. You should pause this video now and come back when you're finished with your discussion posts and you've looked at your classmates' comments. So you may have noticed that there are many rights missing from this document. Like, it doesn't even say that you have a right to your life, or a right to equality, or a right to vote. That's because this document was written by rich white dudes who owned a lot of property, including enslaved people. So these men already had their basic necessities covered and then some. And their worst fear was the government taking away their property, whether that was guns or land or slaves. And they didn't want to create any rights that would force them to free their slaves or share their property with poor people. So they created a list of mostly negative rights. Things the government cannot do to you. But a lot of people today think we need a list of positive rights, things that all people should have, including education, healthcare, housing, and a long list of other stuff. Some other countries with newer constitutions have a list of positive rights, but the United States does not. However, some additional rights have been added to the Constitution over time with more amendments. Three of these amendments were added after the Civil War, when slavery finally became illegal. The 13th Amendment abolished slavery, except as a punishment for someone convicted of a crime. The 14th Amendment introduced the word equal into the Constitution and said the government has to treat all groups of people equally. The 15th Amendment guaranteed men of all races the right to vote, and the 19th Amendment extended that right to women. Now, just because these rights were on paper, that doesn't mean that everyone actually got these rights in real life. Throughout U.S. history, people of color had to fight to get these rights added to the Constitution, and then had to keep fighting to make the government actually respect these rights. Even today, there's a big gap between the rights people are supposed to have and the rights they actually get in real life. That's what we're going to start discussing tomorrow. Thanks for watching. I'll see you tomorrow.